though we have already done it, but I'm revising it again. Objectives of accounting. Why the accounting has been made? What is the purpose of accounting? Why we are doing accounting? The first purpose of accounting, the first objective of making the accounting is maintaining accounting records. That we need to record the accounts. Whatever information is there in the business, that some people are paying cash, to some people we need to pay cash in future, and some people are buying in credit, some people are buying in cash. So we need to maintain a record of all that. Only the monetary records are made in the accounting. So we say that maintaining accounting records is the main objective of business, main objective of accounting. That is why we are doing accounting, right? Maintaining accounting records. Then the second objective is determining profit or loss. Determining profit or loss means that every businessman wants to know that what is the profit that we have earned or what is the loss that we have incurred. So our second objective is determining profit or loss. What is our profit and what is our loss, right? Determining profit or loss. And then the third objective of the business is determining financial position. My voice is not coming. My voice is not coming to all of you. It must be coming, Himanshi. Please type in the chat box, my voice is coming or not?
This is coming.
Coming. Okay, Himanshi, please find in your WebEx. Is there some problem in the WebEx? That is why my voice is not coming. Okay, so many of the students have typed that it is coming. Okay, so now moving. Now it is coming? Okay, then fine, good. Now, third objective of accounting is determining financial position. Determining financial position is another objective of accounting is that we determine the financial position through the balance sheet. That on a particular date, generally at the end of the accounting year, that is on 31st March or on 31st December, what is our financial position? What are the assets available to the businessman and what are the liabilities of the businessman? This is what we want to know. And we get to know this financial position through balance sheet. Then fourth point is facilitating management. Facilitating management means that as a student, you get the pocket money and you can make records that I have spent this much amount on buying chocolates. I have spent this much amount in going outside with friends. I spent this much amount in going to Rohini Metro Walk Mall and I spent this much amount on rides. So when you look at your expenses and this much amount I spent on purchasing the books and this much amount I spent on purchasing the stationery. So when you look at your expenses, you just get to know that without even realizing I am overspending a lot of money in parting out. So I should control this expense. So in future, what you are doing is that it does not mean that you have stopped parting. You are going outside. But now you are spending the appropriate amount on that particular aspect of your life. So it facilitates in the same way. Accounting facilitates management. By looking at our expenses, the businessman comes to know that I have overspended this much money here. This thing I could have purchased from this place in the wholesale rate. I purchased it from this market. And it was expensive to me. So in this way, the management can take decisions for the future. That in future, I will not be behaving like this. In future, I will be purchasing this thing from here. In future, I will be selling this thing like this only. The profit margin will be this. So accounting helps the management in taking the future decisions. Then fifth point is providing accounting information to users. Providing accounting information to users, I already explained you that there are internal users as well as external users in business. Internal users are the management, the owners of the organization. they want to know the profit and loss, they want to know the financial position, they want to know about the cost incurred, they want to know about the expenses. So accounting information is useful to internal users. And then who are our external users? In external users, government is there. Government wants to know our income, and from our income, government will be charging us tax. And then the money lenders want to know our financial position, that if they have a good financial position, only then we will be giving them loan. Then there are investors also who want to buy the shares of that company. So they will just check the accounts of that company, whether the company is in profit or in losses from the past year. If the company is in profits, that means the company will be giving good dividends to the shareholders. So we will purchase the shares of that company. So in this way, accounting information is useful to users. That is another objective of accounting. Then the sixth objective of accounting is protecting business assets. Protecting business assets is that to have records of assets owned by the business. Accounting maintains records of assets owned by the business, which enables the management to protect them and exercise control. We take care of our assets. We get to know that this much assets we have and how we will be using them and how we will be protecting them. What is the amount of depreciation that we should charge, that in the future we have enough amount to replace the asset. So these were the objectives. We have already discussed them. Now again, today I revised. Now coming to the functions of accounting. In this chapter, all the points which are coming, they are kind of a repetition of what we did in the last point. Like objectives, functions, all these things, importance, need of accounting. All these points, you will see that they are kind of interrelated all the time. Because this is the first chapter and it is kind of introducing to the students what accounting actually is. What do we mean by accounting, right? So the first point is maintaining functions of accounting. What accounting does? Again, same point, maintaining systematic accounting records. This time I am asking you, because kind of similar points we did in objectives also. So explain me this first point. Only one student will go unmute and that student will be explaining. So let us ask Pranav. Yes, Pranav, explain maintaining account systematic accounting records. Yes, Pranav, explain. Are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, explain about how functions of accounting, then maintaining systematic accounting records as a function of accounting. Explain this point.
I'm recording the financial transaction.
Recording the data. That is what you are saying, that this is the function of accounting, that we will record purchases, we will record sales. We will record purchases return, we will record about debtors, we will record about creditors. So this is the function of accounting, that whatever monetary transactions and events are taking place in the business, we are recording them, we are writing them. This is bookkeeping. We saw about this in the story as well. Yes. Second point, who will be explaining? Preparation of financial statements. Yes, mute yourself now, Pranav. Good. Akash, explain a preparation of financial statements.
Ma'am, financial statement means last mein accounting ek period banana. Matlab last mein kitna
last hua hai. Mein jo hum accounts banate hain unhe hum financial statements bolte hain. Financial statements yes, hoti hain hamari profit and loss account aur balance sheet. Theek hai. Yes, anything further you want to explain? ठीक है, तो अकाउंटिंग हमारी हेल्प करती है फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स को बनाने में, मतलब प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट को बनाने में और बैलेंस शीट को बनाने में. यस, थर्ड पॉइंट, कैन एनीवन एक्सप्लेन थर्ड पॉइंट? मीटिंग लीगल रिक्वायरमेंट्स. थर्ड पॉइंट, एनीवन हु वांट्स टू एक्सप्लेन थर्ड पॉइंट? अविरल, कैन यू एक्सप्लेन थर्ड पॉइंट? भावार्थ, कैन यू एक्सप्लेन थर्ड पॉइंट? नो
ईटिंग
यस 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 गुड गुड एक्सप्लेन. एक्सप्लेन बेटा, आई कैन लिसन यू. गुड एक्सप्लेन. आई नो यू कैन एक्सप्लेन वेरी नाइसली. एक्सप्लेन.
Accounting records are accepted as evidence by the court of law, and they are maintained systematically.
Right. Anything else? Like, I know your father is a CA. You must have seen him that whenever this 31st March comes, and whenever the time of income tax return to file the income tax returns comes, he must be saying ke income tax ki returns file karni hai. This time his office must be filled with all the clients. Clients must be coming, they must be sitting outside waiting that we need to file the income tax returns. Why? Because government says that till this date you need to give your accounts to us so that we can charge income tax from you. You need to submit your tax. So there are many legal requirements. The government has made many a things that you need to show us your accounts for this and this purpose. So for various legal requirements, for meeting those legal requirements, we need to accounting. Like a person is doing business, that person has earned income throughout the year, then he will be making the accounts and then he will be depositing income tax. And there are many other legal requirements for which we need accounting, right? And accounts can be used as evidence in the court. They can be shown in the court as proof that this is the proof that if someone has, for example, someone is not giving us our money, that debtor has become bad, that debtor needs to pay me 1 lakh rupees. And now he is not paying my 1 lakh rupees and he is lying that I don't owe you any money. Mujhe aapke koi paise dene hi nahi the. Aap mujhse kaise paise ki demand kar sakte hai. At that time, I will have the
Ma'am,
proof.
Ma'am, toh debt trap ho gaya na.
Bad debt ho gaya wo. Wo debtor bad ho gaya. That will be bad debt. So I will not accept ki bad debt ho gaya toh ho gaya. I will file a case against him that please pay my money. I can see that you are going outside India, traveling here and there, and you are enjoying with my 1 lakh rupees. First pay my 1 lakh rupees and then go wherever you want to go. So I will file a case against him. But in court, he can say that I don't owe her any money at all. Mujhe to inke koi paise dene hi nahi the. At that time, what will I do? At that time, I will show the voucher. I will show the bill that on this particular date, this person purchased this much product from me and he said that I will be paying money after 3 months. So this is the bill with me. I will show it as a proof in the court. So that is why we need accounting, right? Now, the fourth point of function of accounting is communicating the account financial information. Again, the same point. That we need to communicate the financial user financial information of our accounts to internal users as well as external users. Then the fifth point, assistance to management, you will be explaining. Who will be explaining? Devanshu. Yes, Devanshu, explain the fifth point. Explain the fifth point, assistance to management. Okay, Devanshu is not here. They've explained the fifth point, assistance to management. Can you explain? When you are explaining, I get to know that you are understanding the subject so that I can move forward. So please quickly explain the points. Assistance to management. Disha, can you explain assistance to management?
Management assistance to management.
Yes.
Management offer, ma'am, it requires the accounting records. And which in turns help the management in decision making. And it will assist the management in protecting the assets and also exercising control.
Yes, very good. Yes, you have explained it very clearly. Now, some students who have missed some of the classes, they must be thinking that what assets is all about, and they must be feeling shy to ask what assets are. Assets are like the property owned by the business. They are the assets of the business, which are there in the business for more than 1 year. And those are called fixed assets, and those whose benefit is consumed within 1 year, they are known as current assets. These basic accounting terms we will be discussing in detail in the second chapter, basic accounting terms. But till then, you also keep on finding information about these basic accounting terms. I have sent you the chapter in the PDF form, and keep on asking from your parents and your elder brothers and sisters that what are assets, what are liabilities, what do we mean by capital, so that you are clear in your mind about these terms, because it is very essential to be clear about the terms, right? Assets are like building is asset, furniture is asset, land is asset, our goodwill is asset, and then in current assets, cash is asset, bank balance is asset. Yes, beta? Bank balance is asset.
Tangible mein aayegi na?
Tangible are the assets which we can see and touch, and goodwill is an intangible asset. Because I cannot see,
yes,
goodwill,
ma'am.
I cannot touch goodwill. The benefit,
yes,
of
ma'am,
goodwill can be experienced, right? Good.
Yes,
so
yes, ma'am. Yes,
so
ma'am,
you have already started. Good. Now coming to advantages of accounting. Please explain about trial balance. Yes, trial balance, Rishabh, it is the 13th chapter. And right now we are on first chapter. But trial balance is what? Trial balance is like when I have made all the accounts. I have made purchases book, sales book, and all the subsidiary books I have made. And then I have made the accounts also. So my ledger is complete. So what do I do is I make a summary of all the ledger accounts, that I make the total of all the accounts, and I have made done the balancing part. And then I'm making a summary. In trial balance, what I do is name of the account, then debit and credit column, right? And then in the name of the account, I write purchases account. Purchases account, debit balance is there, how much is the balance? Then sales account, credit balance, how much is the amount, credit balance. Ram account, whatever the balance is. Sham account, whatever the balance is, I write in that column. And then I total it. And from these accounts only, I make the profit and loss account and balance sheet. Right, this is the 13th chapter. If you have the book, you can study from that book. Now, quickly coming to advantages of accounting. Advantages of accounting, that what are the benefits of accounting? Advantages of accounting is financial information about business. Accounting gives us information about the business, what are the profits we have earned, what are the losses we have incurred, or what is our financial position at the end of the accounting period. Then assistance to management, again these points are repeating. Assistance to management, it helps the management in making plans for the future, for taking decisions, and for controlling the expenses which we might have done over in the last years. Then replaces memory. Replaces memory again from that story that John did not record anything. So John found it very difficult when people are coming to him for asking money. So it replaces memory. Human memory, like I cannot remember each and every transaction. I cannot remember each and everything. So what am I doing is I make a record, a written record. Someone is on unmute. Manyan Akpal, Peter. I have. Yes, now coming to third point is replaces memory, that it is very difficult for a human being to remember all the transactions, the amount of all the transactions. So we make it in writing through accounting. So it is an advantage that we need not remember each and everything. Then facilitates comparative study. Comparison we always do, like with our marks, what we do is we compare the marks of first term with the marks of second term. And then we also make a comparison that sometimes what we are doing is some of the students, they make it a point that 20% marks of first term, 20% marks of second term. And now in the final term, how much marks we need to get pass. So this is the comparison you make. So comparative study in business means that we compare that what were our profits last year. Now they have increased or have they decreased. So accounting helps us in making this comparative study. We make comparison with other business firms also. Like I make a comparison of my profits with the similar firms in the industry. That whether they are also earning the similar profit, am I earning less profit or am I earning more profits than them? Then facilitate settlement of tax liabilities. Depending on our income, I pay the tax. Depending on my income, depending on my purchases and sales, I pay the GST, goods and services tax. Then facilitates loan. Loan is given to us by banks or other institutions when we are showing them our accounts. If I have a good financial record, bank will easily give me loan if I want to open up a new factory or if I want to open up a new shop or a new showroom. If I already have a showroom which is running in profits, then the bank will easily give me loan. Then evidence in court. Evidence in court, we have already discussed that the accounting records can be used to show us as a proof in court. Facilitate sale of business. For example, I want to sell my business. In that case, I will show the accounts to the parties who are interested in purchasing my business. And according to my accounting records, they will be negotiating the deal with me. Then assistance in the event of insolvency. Insolvency means that when a person is left with no money at all, that person has become bankrupt. Bankrupt ho gaya, uske paas kuch bhi nahi bacha hai. At that time, he will declare that I have become insolvent. He will give a notice in the newspaper that this and this business is declared to be insolvent, is declared to be bankrupt, right? So in that case also, accounting helps us. Then helpful in partnership accounts. In partnership, what we do is that many partners are there. They are sharing profits. They have a profit sharing ratio. Partnership accounts, we will be studying in class 12th in detail. And so accounting is helpful to the partners in sharing the profits, how they will be getting the salary, what will be the interest on capital, what will be the interest on drawings in that case. Then helpful in decision making. This we have already discussed, that accounting is helpful in making the decisions, like the amount withdrawn by the proprietor, what the amount the proprietor, the owner is taking out of the business for personal use, the price at which goods should be sold, that this is my cost price, I should add this much profit margin and then I should sell it. So these were all the advantages of accounting. Now we will be discussing limitations of accounting. Limitations of accounting are, first limitation that always comes to our mind is the third point, that is accounting ignores the qualitative elements. It is only recording the transactions and events which can be measured in monetary terms, and it is totally ignoring the aspects. Dhruv is saying, please show the screen. Screen is there. I'm sharing the screen, Dhruv. Yes, now the first point is accounting is not fully exact. Accounting is not fully exact in spite of the fact that most transactions are recorded on the basis of evidence, yet some estimates are made. Like what I do is in the business, I have purchased the machinery and I need to calculate the depreciation. So I just make it an estimate in my mind for calculating the amount of depreciation, that the useful life of the machinery should be 10 years. ये machinery 10 years तक चलेगी. I have purchased this truck. This truck will be in working condition till 5 years or till 10 years. So what I am doing is I am making an estimate. Then there are debtors in the business. Debtors are who will be giving me money. So I will be making an estimate in my mind. शायद ये डेटर मेरे पैसे नहीं देगा फ्यूचर में. प्लीज म्यूट योर सेल्फ. राइट, सो दिस इज एन एस्टिमेट आई मेड इन माई माइंड दैट दिस डेटर मे नॉट बी गिविंग माई मनी, ही मे टर्न बैड. सो आई हैव डाउट ओवर हिम. सो आई एम मेकिंग, मे बी ही इज गिविंग माई मनी, मे नॉट बी गिविंग माई मनी. So this is, then I am making estimate that this product should be sold in this much of amount. It will be sold in this much amount in future. So in accounting, though I am doing everything exact, I told you in that story that accounting is not about generally. I want to know my exact profit. I want to know the accurate amount. But still while making the accounts, the accountant needs to make some estimates. So this is one limitation of accounting, is that accounting is not fully exact. Then there is unrealistic information. Unrealistic information means that since accounting statements are prepared following the accounting concepts and conventions, for example, going concern concept, this we will be studying in the third chapter. What the accounting going concern concept says that when we are making accounts and or when we are starting a business, we just assume that the business will go on forever and we have no intention to shut it down in the near future. So this is an unrealistic information. Whatever business we have started, we will definitely close it one day or the other. So this is one unrealistic information which is there in the business. Some student is on unmute. Please mute yourself. Otherwise, other students will not be able to listen to my voice clearly. So please mute yourself. Please be careful about that. So there is some unrealistic information while making the accounts because we cannot see in the future. Yet we make estimates about the future. And then third point, accounts. Now coming to accounting ignores the qualitative elements. This we have discussed already, that accounting records only and only the transactions and events which can be measured in terms of money. Other transactions or events, howsoever important they may be to the business, they cannot be recorded. For example, the death of a very good manager, the death of a loyal employee, or if the owner has owner is not ill, or the good public relations with the customers, or the good environment of the organization, that cannot be recorded in the accounting. Then accounting ignores the effect of price level changes. There is a concept known as historical cost concept. Historical cost concept says that in accounting, we will record the assets at their purchase price, at their historical cost, and we will not be changing the amount again and again according to the price level changes, because the price keeps on changing, but we will not be changing the accounts again and again because it will make our accounts unstable. So accounting ignores the effect of price level changes. Accounting may lead to window dressing. This is a very practical limitation which he has given us. For example, yes.
Ma'am, please explain the fourth point again.
Now moving forward to accounting may lead to window dressing. This is a very practical point that is given here, is that in accounts what we are doing is the situation is something else and we are showing something else through the accounts. My company is in losses, but I don't want to make it public. मैं किसी को नहीं बताना चाहती हूँ मेरी कंपनी में लॉस हो रहा है. क्यों नहीं बताना चाहती हूँ? Because then no one will purchase my share. पब्लिक में कोई मेरे शेयर्स परचेज ही नहीं करेगा. सो व्हाट आई हैव डन इज आई हैव टोल्ड द अकाउंटेंट दैट मेक द अकाउंट्स इन सच अ फॉर्म. आप सेल्स को थोड़ा ज़्यादा दिखा दो, एक्स्ट्रा बिल अपने आप बना लो वाउचर्स एंड शो इट समथिंग लाइक दिस दैट माई अकाउंट्स आर नॉट शोइंग एनी लॉसेस. एंड वॉट आई एम डूइंग इज सेकेंड सिचुएशन इज दैट आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू शो मोर प्रॉफिट्स, क्योंकि मुझे इनकम टैक्स ज़्यादा देना पड़ेगा, इसलिए मैं ज़्यादा प्रॉफिट शो नहीं करना चाहती. तो वॉट आई एम डूइंग इज मैंने डिप्रिसिएशन कुछ ज़्यादा शो कर दिया अपने प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट में, कि इतना से मेरी असेट की वैल्यू डिप्रिशिएट हो गई है, गिर गई है मेरे असेट्स की वैल्यू, तो वो मेरे लिए एक नॉन कैश एक्सपेंस है. तो मैंने ज़्यादा एक्सपेंसेस शो कर दिए अपनी बुक्स में और मैंने उसके वजह से टैक्स को कम पे करा, मेरा प्रॉफिट कम आया और मैंने टैक्स कम पे करा. ठीक है, तो अकाउंटिंग में लीड टू विंडो ड्रेसिंग. द टर्म विंडो ड्रेसिंग मीन्स मैनिपुलेशन ऑफ अकाउंट्स. आई एम डूइंग मैनिपुलेशन इन द अकाउंट्स इन अ वे सो एज टू कंसील वाइटल फैक्ट्स, इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स एंड प्रेजेंट द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स टू शो अ बेटर पोजिशन देन वट इट एक्चुअली इज. आई एम शोइंग अ डिफरेंट पोजिशन फ्रॉम द एक्चुअल पोजिशन. इन दिस सिचुएशन इनकम स्टेटमेंट दैट इज प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट फेल्स टू प्रोवाइड अ ट्रू एंड फेयर व्यू ऑफ द रिजल्ट ऑफ ऑपरेशंस एंड द बैलेंस शीट फेल्स टू प्रोवाइड अ ट्रू एंड फेयर व्यू ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल पोजिशन ऑफ द एंटरप्राइज. सो द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ, आई एम अगेन रिपीटिंग द पॉइंट्स ऑफ लिमिटेशंस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग. अकाउंटिंग इज नॉट फुली एग्जैक्ट, वी आर मेकिंग एस्टिमेट्स एंड अकाउंट, सम ऑफ द एस्टिमेट्स वी आर मेकिंग. अनरियलिस्टिक इंफॉर्मेशन इज ऑल्सो देयर. वी आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन द गोइंग कंसर्न कंसेप्ट. वी नीड टू यूज दिस कॉन्सेप्ट, इट इज अ रूल. Then accounting ignores the qualitative elements. It records only the information which can be measured in terms of money. Then accounting ignores the effect of price level changes. There are changes in the price in the money as a measurement unit, but we don't record them in the books of accounts because we are following historical cost concept. And then accounting may lead to window dressing when we are manipulating the accounts. And we are showing only that picture which we want to show to others. We are not showing the real picture. This is what we are doing.